So you're learning this dance called Ghumar, and it is from India's northern state, west and northern state. Rajasthan is the deserts in India. It's called Rajasthan. Now, Rajasthan is a very conservative state where women usually don't even show their faces. So their scarf, like if they wear a scarf, is supposed to hide this much of their face. So Ghumar dance is generally done like this. You don't even show your face. It's because Ghumar is generally done when a new bride comes into the house and she's welcomed. They don't dance in front of other men. Just her husband is allowed to be present, but all women have covered their faces and they're dancing. Ghumar, in essence, means spinning. That is what it is in Hindi. That's the language. Ghumar means spinning. So this type of dance has various different types of spins in it. It's very repetitive. It's supposed to be repetitive because remember, this is a folk dance. They are not technically trained women who know how to point their feet or flex it. They are doing this out of just, it's almost like soul dancing. You have to feel it and you do it, and then it's like a community dancing as well. So if you're repeating it, everyone can start being a part of it. So if you do two moves and then move to another move and another, then you can't get the whole community involved. So once you get married and you come to this new house and the bride is dancing or around her people are dancing, she can join in and she can be a part of it. So this was ages ago, like years and years ago in India, really olden times, even before we got independence. We got our independence in 1947. So it is from ancient times that Ghumar has been going on. So now, because it's been going on for such a long time, there are techniques that have formed around it. So even though in the villages of India, if you go and see Ghumar, it's repetitive and there is no structure to it, but now it's been developed as a dance form which has techniques, so it can be taught. And once you know it, then it is so easy to just drown in it almost. You just go with the flow. Once the music starts and you start those spins, and of course if you have vertigo you might have to watch that. But there are other moves, it's not just group spins. So you just will go in the flow. So my dance studio has an annual recital every year. Growing up, I took ballet, tap, jazz, and I also, because I grew up a lot of my life in Saudi Arabia, so I took a lot of belly dancing, and we got a lot of Indian dancing too. I got classical dance background, and I got a lot of folk dance background. So what happened was we used to do recitals, and my kids are very involved in dances, so I go and watch their recitals. Recitals can get boring. I mean, how many ballet or tap or jazz or ghumar or bhangra or Bharatanatyam or Kathak, all of these style dances, how many can you see one after the other, after the other, and after the other? After a while, once you've seen your own child, you're like, okay. Either you walk off or you're polite and you sit there, doze off maybe. My husband does that at times. So when I started my studio and I wanted to do a recital, I decided that it will not be dance after dance. The best part about the studio is that I can incorporate everything in it because it's Bollywood, and Bollywood is a blend. It's like a mixing pot, just like the America, right? It's a mixing pot of people, different people. Bollywood is a mixing pot of all different styles. So I can put elements of jazz, elements of tap, elements of ghumar, elements of kathak, elements of bhangra, elements of garba. I mean, there's so many different styles into Bollywood and create different dances.